Hello students, welcome to this online course of strength of materials. So previously we have finished our first two chapters, that was first was the simple stress and strain and second was compound stresses and strains. So now we are going to start our new chapter, which is the shear force and bending moment. Okay, so let us start. Why we are going to start, like why we want to study the shear stress and bending moment? Because these are the primary concerns while designing a beam. So in your houses or many places you can see the beams. So for designing those beams, we must have the idea of the variation of bending moment and shear stress at various points. So that is why we must be having the knowledge of bending moment and shear force in a given beam, how we are going to calculate. So if somebody is saying analyze this beam, that means he is asking the variation of shear force and the bending moment throughout that beam. So let us see what is a beam, how we are going to decide the type of structure. The structural members are usually classified according to the types of load that they support. So same structure can be act as beam, it can be act as column, depending upon the loading. So loading decide the type of structure. So what are beam? What is a beam? Beams are structural members subjected to lateral loads, that is forces or moments having their vectors perpendicular to the axis of the bar. So beams are generally transversely loaded. Okay, so beams must be it is a definition of beam only, like it will be subjected to lateral load. So this is the axis and this is the load acting in a lateral direction or transverse direction. Okay, so if the same member is loaded by the axial force, okay, so it is not a beam, right? Not it will, it can be a column, it can, it will be termed as an axial member. So depending upon the loading and the direction of loading, we can classify the structures. The beams are classified as planar. This we have already, like in detail, we have studied in engineering mechanics. So if you are, I will be not covering whole beam and all. I have taught you the types of structures and how to calculate the various reactions. So just to go through engineering mechanics lectures. Now the beams are classified as planar structure. You can see here, because they lie in a single plane. If all loads act in that same plane, and if all deflections occur in that plane, then we refer to that plane as the plane of bending. So if everything is in the single plane, then that plane will become the plane of bending. If like there are two planes are there in which the deflection is there and let's say moment is there, then it will be biaxial bending, because the bending is having two different directions. So finding the shear force and bending moments is an essential step in the design of any beam. So this we must be very clear. If a question has been asked like analyze this beam, that means that person is asking you to determine the variation of shear force and the bending moment along that beam. Maybe axial force may also come. So axial force is also a part of analysis of beam only. So we usually need to know not only the maximum value of these quantities, but also the manner in which they vary along the axis. Once the shear force and bending moments are known, we can find the stresses, strains and deflection in the beam. So you can see we are moving step by step. First we have seen the statics part in which the body was rigid. Now we have moved forward and we are saying that the body can be deformed, like it can have deformation, it can have deflections. Now in the next semester, when you will be doing the fifth semester, so you will be seeing the design of beam. First we have studied what is beam and how we are going to calculate loads in mechanics. Now in this we are going to see how the internal stresses or internal reaction, that are bending moment, shear forces, are going to be, and we will be seeing the maximum values. We have to determine the maximum value, because in the next semester you are going to design that beam for that maximum value, so that beam will be safe. So this is a step by step process. So is that's why you have to be very clear about the mechanics and strength of material before moving forward in the next semester, because there you will be seeing the structures also. So in this unit you will be seeing the only determinate bodies, but in the next semester while doing the structure analysis course you will like encounter the indeterminate structures also. Okay, so you have to be you have to correlate all the like theory and concepts throughout. Now beams are usually described by the manner in which they are supported. So depending upon the support, we have seen like in the previous semester, like simply supported beam was there, bending cantilever beam was there, fixed beam is there, and overhang beams are there. So depending upon the loading condition and the support conditions, we can have different types of beams. So you can see here, like for example, a beam with a pin support at one end and roller support at the other is called a simply supported beam. So you can see here in this beam, this is hinge support, this is roller support. So this is a simply supported beam. This can be a simple beam. It is the simple possible beam. Okay. So the essential feature of a pin support is that it prevents translation at the end of a beam, but does not prevent rotation. So this, there is no you can see there are two reactions. So these two reactions will avoid the horizontal and vertical movement, but you can see there is no reactive moment is there. If no reactive moment is there, that means if a moment will act, this will move like this. This is quite like higher value I'm showing just for like sake of showing, but it can rotate. So hinge support can only prevent the deformations, not the moments or the rotation. Now you can see the end A is your horizontal like hinge support, and end B is your own roller support. So roller support only prevent the perpendicular deformation. Okay, so only RB can act. So that means if here also roller is there, so they can move horizontally. So roller support only prevent one direction, the deformation in only one direction, that is perpendicular to that roller. Now the beam shown in here, you can see the figure 2B, this is which is fixed at one end and free at other end. So this type of beam is called as cantilever beam, this we already know, and this is the general loading condition. This type of loading can occur, like inclined load are there and uniformly varying load are there. And what is the property of fixed support? It can have a reactive moment. You can see here MA is there, which is a reactive moment. That means the beam is not going to rotate. So if load is there, this will be remain like this and it will bend like this. So here no rotation is possible. In this way you can also have the overhang beam. So overhang beams means a simply supported beam like this. Sorry. So if it is like this, so this is your beam. So this part from here to here is overhanging beam, overhang part. So like this you can have different types of beams. This that we are going to see when we will be solving the problems. Now what is axial force or what is axial thrust? So axial force at any section of a beam is equal to the algebraic sum of the forces parallel to the axis. So what will be the axial, what is the axial force? So this, if this is your member, so perpendicular to along this direction, if some force is here or some force is here, so these are the axial forces which are parallel to the axis of that particular body. And what is axial force? So if at this point I want to calculate axial force, so it can be the algebraic sum of all the forces on either left or right. Okay, from both ways we can calculate the axial force. In the same manner, shear force is at any section of a body is equal to the algebraic sum. So what is shear force? Shear force is nothing but the shear, means for this force is trying to shear this body. So that means it will be a ट्रांसवर्स फोर्स इफ एट दिस सेक्शन आई वॉन्ट टू कैलकुलेट शेयर फोर्स इफ दिस इज पी सो बाई सिमेट्री इट विल बिकम पी बाई टू एंड पी बाई टू ओके सो इफ दिस इज आवर सेक्शन एक्स सिक्स सो ऑन द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड यू कैन सी पी बाई टू इज देयर एंड ऑन द राइट हैंड साइड यू कैन सी माइनस पी प्लस पी बाई टू दैट मीन्स पी बाई टू इज देयर बट ऑफ अपोजिट साइन सो दैट इज ऑब्वियस बिकॉज इट विल हैव एक्शन एंड रिएक्शन पेयर सो हियर इट इज प्लस पी बाई टू एंड हियर इट इज माइनस पी बाई टू बट द शेयर फोर्स इज नॉट कैलकुलेटेड लाइक दिस लाइक प्लस वॉट एवर वी हैव सीन टिल नाउ प्लस माइनस दैट वी आर गोइंग टू से इन द साइन कन्वेंशन पार्ट हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू से दिस इज पॉजिटिव शेयर एंड हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू से दिस इज नेगेटिव शेयर बट एट राइट नाउ वी हैव टू सी लाइक एट एनी सेक्शन इफ शेयर फोर्स वी वॉन्ट टू कैलकुलेट वी हैव टू टेक द एल्जेब्रिक सम ऑफ द फोर्सेज आइदर ऑन द लेफ्ट और ऑन द राइट ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर सेक्शन and in the same manner the bending moment is also calculated like this only we have to take the section we have to add all the moments from the right hand side of that section or all the moments from left hand side of that moment so what is bending moment bending moment is a internal reaction of a external force so let us say this is your beam okay so if this load is there so this load is trying to bend this okay so if it will like we are trying to bend this bar it is like it will become like this so internally it will develop some reactions so it can be shear force or it can be bending moment or it can be axial force so these three are the internal reactions to the external applied loads what we are applying externally the body will react and how it will react in the form of axial force it can be in the form of shear force or it can be a form of bending moment now we can deal with a bit like axial force differently right now we are going to see bending moment and shear force because in the next coming lecture you will be seeing that there is a proper relationship between shear force and bending moment so right now we are going to focus on shear force and bending moment only So when a beam is loaded by forces or couples, stresses and strains are created throughout the interior of the beam. As I have told you, the body will react and it will develop various kind of internal reactions. To determine these stresses and strain, we first must find the internal forces and internal couples that act on section of the beam. So we have to first to find the stresses and all, we have to first find the reactions. So reaction is nothing but the bending moment and shear force and axial force so for an illustration you can see here so this is your a particular beam is there AB so we are taking an like at section MN we have taken so what we can like separate the beam into two parts so left hand side is this and right hand side is this so this is your given force so internal reaction will develop like this so shear force and we will be using B for shear force and M for bending moment so you can see here if V is like downwards here so V will be upward here like action reaction pair and if here you can see anti clockwise here it is clockwise so like this we are going to check the values and now what we will be doing to determine the V and M value we will be taking the equilibrium condition like equilibrium of the body and we will find V and M so from simple statics you can say the V is equal to P only and moment we can say P into X so that we are going to see how in much more detail we will be solving lots of problems now we cut through the beam at a cross section MN locate at a distance X from free end and isolate the left hand part of the beam so this we have already seen Now the free body is held in equilibrium by the force P and by the stresses that act over the cross section. These stresses represent the action of the right hand part of the beam on the left hand part. So action reaction we will be seeing. So left hand side whatever forces are coming from the right hand side and on right hand part whatever forces are there they are coming due to left hand part. At this stage of our discussion we do not know the distribution of stresses. So we are not knowing any distribution how it is acting. All we know that is the resultant of these stresses must be such that to maintain the equilibrium of the body. So this is like sure, we are sure that the body in equilibrium and it must have the, we must, it the forces which are acting must be acting to maintain the equilibrium of the body. because if the body is in equilibrium, you can cut into infinite parts. All the infinite parts will be in equilibrium if the whole body is in equilibrium. So right now we are having this knowledge only. We do not know the stress distribution. From statics, we know that the resultant of stresses acting on the cross section can be reduced to a shear force and bending moment. So all the forces can be reduced to a force and a moment couple that we have already seen. Now, because the load P is transverse to the axis of beam, no axial force exists at the cross section. So right now we are only dealing with shear force and bending moment. And both the shear force and bending moment act in the plane of the beam. So this you can see the plane and the moment is perpendicular because R cross F is there. So that you already know. Now shear force and bending moment, like axial force in the bars and internal torques in the shaft, are the resultant of stress distribution over the cross section. So these are nothing but the stress resultant only. So these quantities, that is shear force and bending moment, are collectively called as shear stress resultant. Because what are these? These are the stress resultant of all the stresses inside the beam, and that we are taking in the we have taken by force and couple. So that is why they are termed as stress resultant. Now let us see how we are going to set our sign convention, which sign convention we are going to use. So let us now consider the sign convention for shear. This is very very important, because without sign convention you will be drawing the diagrams very very wrong. So if sign is not correct, then you will be losing your marks. So it is customary to assume that shear force and bending moment are positive when they act in the direction as shown in figure 3b. 3b is what? This is your figure 3b. So if this is the direction of shear force and bending moment, then they will be positive. I will explain in more detail what does it mean. So note that the shear force tend to rotate the material clockwise, and the bending moment tends to compress the upper material of the beam and elongate the lower part. So we have to check what, like here also you can see this surface. First we have to decide the surface, for which surface we are drawing this all the things. So generally we used to take the top fiber or the upper portion of that body. So if you can see here, this top portion, this red line is there. So what this M is trying to do, it is trying to compress it. And again, this M is also trying to compress it. So if the moment, bending moment, which is generated internally, is trying to compress that particular surface, then it will be termed as positive bending moment or sagging bending moment. Okay. So again, you have to check. And the shear force, what it is trying to do, it is trying to rotate it clockwise. Okay, or in other words, you can see, like if this is your body and the shear force is upward, okay, on the left hand side and downward on the right hand side. So you can see this is the section, and at the left if it is upward and in the right if it is downward, then that shear will be positive. And if you are going to reverse the case, then it will be negative. Okay, negative, like bending moment, what it will be do? It will try to expand the surface. So here you can see, this is the surface, and this, due to this moment, what is going to happen? This surface is going to expand. So that will be become, if that moment is producing the tension in that particular fiber or particular surface, then it will be termed as negative. And the shear, if is like opposite to that, that means in the left hand side if it is downwards and right hand side of the section if it is upward, then it will be what? Negative shear. So sign convention is very very important while drawing. You can have your own sign convention, but while drawing the bending moment diagram and shear force diagram, you have to mention it properly. Okay. Also in this instance, the shear force acts downwards and the bending moment acts counterclockwise. So this thing I have already explained you. Now we must recognize that the algebraic sign of the shear stress resultant is determined by how it deforms the material on which it acts, rather than by its direction in space. So direction, like You can say this shear force is acting upward, but it is negative because it is the like how it is going to deform that body. It matters a lot than the direction in the space. This is downwards, but still this is shear force. So it is downwards, but still it is positive. So it is the way in which that particular force is acting, how that effect is more important in this chapter, not the its direction in space. Here also it is positive and negative. So you can see this part has been compressed and this part has been expanded due to moments. That is why it is negative and that is why it is positive. So a positive bending moment. So first we can see a positive shear force acts clockwise against a material and a negative shear force acts counterclockwise. So this we have already seen. A positive bending moment compress the upper part of the beam and a negative bending moment compress the lower part of the beam. So it depends on the portion which we are going to use. If you are taking the upper portion, the sign convention will be same. If you are going to change the surface, the sign convention will be different. So you have to choose the sign convention very wisely and you have to stick to it. Okay, so sign convention is very very important. Now to make this convention clear, both positive and negative shear force and bending moment in the previous diagram, as I have shown you, the forces and moments are shown acting on at element of the beam cut out between two cross section that are small at a smaller distance. So the deformation of the element caused by positive and negative shear forces. So you can see how the negative and positive shear forces are going to deform that particular body in this diagram. So positive shear force tend to deform the element by causing the right hand face to move downward. You can see this right hand part is, so it was the original material. So here it is, it has come down, and here it is as it is with respect to the left hand surface. And the positive bending moment compresses the upper part of the beam and elongate the lower part. Sign convention for stress resultants are called deformation sign convention because they are based upon the how material is being deformed. So we previously used a deformation sign convention in dealing with the axial. So in the first chapter we used to say if the body is expanding, so it is positive deformation. If body is, so tensile force was what? It was the force which was expanding that particular material. So in the same manner here also, it is the deformation which is deciding the nature of the force, like whether it will be positive shear or negative shear, whether it will be positive bending moment or negative bending moment. It is depending upon the nature of deformation of that particular force on that particular body. So we stated that an axial force producing elongation in a bar is positive and an axial force producing shortening is negative. Thus the sign of that axial force depends upon how it deforms the material, not upon the direction in space. So by contrast, when writing equation of equilibrium, we use static sign convention in which forces are positive or negative according to their direction along the coordinate axis. So as we have already seen this, if we are summing forces in y direction, so what we should do, in if we are having this is y axis and x axis, so what if the force is along the positive axis, then we will write plus of that force, and if it is in negative y direction, then we will write minus. But here it is not like that. It is the deformation which is defining the nature of that particular force. So this particular type of bending moment which we are seeing here, so this is the sagging. Let me write on the next page. So if a beam is, so it let me just delete it. So this is sagging bending moment, and reverse of this is hogging. ओके सो दिस यू हैव टू बी वेरी क्लियर इन द क्वेश्चन. इट कैन बी आस्क्ड व्हाट इज द मैक्सिमम सैगिंग बेंडिंग मोमेंट, व्हाट इज द मैक्सिमम हॉगिंग बेंडिंग मोमेंट. सो दिस यू हैव टू बी वेरी केयरफुल. द पॉजिटिव बेंडिंग मोमेंट इज सैगिंग एंड द नेगेटिव बेंडिंग मोमेंट इज द हॉगिंग बेंडिंग मोमेंट. सो इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू सी सम मोर पॉइंट्स अबाउट शेयर फोर्स एंड बेंडिंग मोमेंट. एंड दिस इज ऑल फॉर टूडे. थैंक यू.